lots of bodies. SSMS on here, so, and I'm not gonna download it. So we're just gonna use this, because you can do SQL in the browser. What is SQL? SQL, or Structured Query Language, is a language designed to allow both technical and non-technical users query, manipulate, and transform data. Should add to before that, and transform data from a relational database. And due to its simplicity, SQL databases provide safe and scalable storage for millions of websites and mobile applications. Most of the websites you see are using some sort of SQL. Like Google, Facebook probably, all those types of websites, Reddit, they're all using SQL. And, you know, that's how you're getting the results. It's taking information that's stored on their SQL servers and outputting it for you. So let's go down. It's just showing you like an example table right there. I'm just gonna go on to begin lesson one. If you've never heard of SQL, you've probably heard of Excel, Microsoft Excel. And there are similar aspects to SQL. It's way more complex, and it's like Excel on steroids, kind of. But you could do a lot of cool things with SQL, actually. So, where's my cursor? Okay, right there. Itself is just a statement which declares what data we are looking for, where to find it in a database, and optionally how to transform it before it is returned. It has has a specific syntax, though, which is what we are going to learn in the following exercises. As we mentioned in the introduction, you can think of a table in SQL as a type of entity, i.e. dogs, and each row in the table as a specific instance of that type, a pug, a beetle, a different colored bug, etc. This means that the columns would then represent the common properties shared by all instances of that entity, color of fur, length of tail, etc. And given a table of data, the most basic query we could write would be one that selects for a couple columns properties of the table with all the rows instances. So we're just going to go down here. The result of this query will be a two-dimensional set of rows. I guess we got to see this a little bit. Effectively a copy of the table, but only with the columns that we requested. If we want to retrieve absolutely all the columns of data from a table, we can then use the asterisk shorthand in place of listing all the column names individually. Select asterisk from my table. This query in particular is really useful because it's a simple way to inspect a table by dumping all the data at once. We will be using a database with data about some of Pixar's classic movies for most of our exercises. This first exercise will only involve the movies table, and the default query below currently shows all the properties of each movie. To continue on to the next lesson, alter the query to find the exact information we need for each task. Okay, let's get started. Find the title of each film. Already showing the title, but let's narrow it down. And if asterisks display everything, what do we want to do? We want to find the title, so we're going to do select title from movies, and there you go. It's showing us all the titles in this particular table. Now, there's a button down here, which is just reset, which is pretty handy. But what I like to do when I was learning is, well, I didn't use this website, but you want to write over and over and over, so it's probably better if you delete it. You're done. Like, you can hit reset and then delete, because the more you write the code, the faster you're gonna learn, and the longer you will remember. So find the director of each film, and it doesn't matter if it's capitalized or not. So select director from my spacebar is broken on my laptop. It's annoying me. Okay, and normally you would write that at the end, but it popped up on this site without that, but that's what you'll normally write at the end of your semicolon at the end of your select statement. so now we want to, let me just go up and see if they show us anything. Yeah, they do. Okay, so I already know what to do, but if you didn't know, you would come up here and look at the information that they give you before, and as you'll see, they have select, column, comma, another column, comma, and you could just keep listing. So that's how we're going to do this one, since it wants two displayed instead of just one. So let's delete that. Select. What do we need? We need title. Title. Comma. And director. From. Movies. There you go. Now we have a title and director. Now what are we going to do for title and year? This one I'm not going to erase everything, because we basically have it what we need here. We're just going to replace director with year. And there you go, now it's done. Now this is just, you know, since this is the first lesson, you're not really seeing the potential for SQL, but it's very useful when you have multiple tables, because you can combine tables together. I'm not really going to get into that, but it's very useful when you need to combine tables that have the same, some of the same information as another table. I'll do more of these if you guys like it, and then you'll see what I'm talking about. But now we're gonna go back and find all the information about each film. So remember what we do for that. Select asterisk from, whoops, from movies. And there you go. See, it's actually, I want to say simple, like the basics of SQL are simple. It seems very, like it's very human language, I guess, the code. Human readable, I guess, compared to a lot of other computer languages. So it's pretty easy to catch on to and learn, especially the basics. Yes, it definitely gets more complex, but since it's human readable, it's a lot of just logic-based coding, which I like about SQL. Anyways, that's it for today. I know this is different, but even if you don't enjoy computer programming, which I'm sure a lot of you won't, hopefully this will be boring and put you to sleep. I will see you on Friday. I was gonna say Wednesday, but it is Wednesday. I will see you on Friday. And as always, if you like this video, please hit the thumbs up. Leave a comment, and if you haven't already, please subscribe. Oh yeah, share too, please. Sharing helps. Sharing is caring. Good night.